It's all good. You're good.
Damn.
Remember the aim for the noose.
Fuck. You and your friend are gonna die to a scat.
All right, remember the other guys around still. Yo, what's good? Don't forget to drop a like and a comment on the video. You know what I'm saying? Help me finesse the algorithm.
Appreciate it.
If you're trying to get better or you're interested on getting better in TARKOV, I highly recommend to check out my coaching course. There's 3 different tiers of coaching, so there will be one that suits you best. It's all one-on-one type sessions, and I might make it into a series. The reason I'm saying this is because prices will have to slowly increase, so if you want to get in now. But anyways, enough talking. Enjoy the video. How long have you been playing?
Well, I started when the game first came out, and then I got bored, and now I'm back.
Okay.
I just haven't had enough time to put in recently.
That's all good. What are we? Not looking too bad. That's 32% survivor rate. KD's okay. What would you say your strongest map is?
I really like customs. That's what I've been playing recently.
Okay. Any maps you want to learn?
I don't know, just any map. I don't really go to any other maps really.
Okay.
Because that's fine. Just the one I'm comfortable with.
Yeah, I was a customs main myself last web. Yeah. Okay. So I have a plan. Plan is, I'll be watching your first couple of games because I'm going to be taking down notes of things that I like and don't like from your gameplay. Okay. I'm going to sum it all up at the end, and then I'll shoot it over Discord DM. Since it is a 2-part session, I'll send it over at the end of tomorrow's session. So you'll always have something to look back at, just in case you don't remember something that I've said, you know.
Okay.
We'll start off with Factory so I can see your mechanics. Since it is small map, close quarters, fast quick game. So you can bring any kit you want, man. I think I'll show you an offline what I mean. It'd be easier to visualize it. And you've already been playing for three wipes. So you should understand what I'm saying pretty easy.
Yeah.
Push into office. Since it's quiet, I would.
Oh.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah, I thought I heard him. I didn't quite know where he was.
It's all good, man. No worries. I was about to say, since it's quiet, it normally means there's a team.
I think it was just one guy. He was just on the stairs.
I heard 2 gunshots.
Oh, dang.
It wasn't lucky, but I'd say try to play for more information before committing to a corner and getting caught off guard.
Okay, yeah.
to be honest with you, a lot of people don't like hearing this because me, myself, I don't like hearing it. But questing is going to help you out so much, especially if you're just trying to get better at PvP. Just being able to have access to the good shit would change the game for you 100%. Okay. Even though you might not have time, try to prioritize that, because you trying to PvP with these kits, you're kind of skimming the bone. And since you only have 6 mil, a lot of people like to overprice the items that you wouldn't have unlocked.
Yeah.
So it's going to be like that right there, 80k for how many bullets? Holy shit.
Yeah,
for 81 bullets, that's insane. Yeah. So yeah, I'd say definitely try to get some quests done. If you're not sure which quest to get done, I'd do a little bit of research and tell you the best ones for your XP.
Yeah.
I wouldn't worry so much about closing doors. Just in case you do get into a fight, you kind of just cut your exit off.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. All right. Play how you normally would. Just prioritize PvP a little bit.
Nope.
Add pain kill before you cross over to the tracks. You always want to do this if you're crossing in open areas.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, that's all recoil, didn't expect that.
Yeah, MCX. And you're running the short bow. And the stock isn't for recoil, it's for ergo, so just remember that if you are fine. I'd always keep that in the back of my head, okay, I have a lot of recoil. If I am gonna full spray, counter it.
Yeah.
And that's another reason to get up close and try barrel stuff because of the recoil. Especially with a 60 rounder, you kind of want to get up close and just fucking mag them. Nice, I like that. Nice, good free look. Do you have any grenades?
What's that?
You have any grenades?
No. Oh, that's the one thing I forgot to buy.
It's all good. I'd go back around the side you came in. Close the door behind you. Yeah. I'd even shoot the light out. And then just keep your ears open.
Yeah. Guess I'll hide my mags here. I don't think anyone will look. Okay. Alright, what do we got?
Rough, quick extract, go for it, man.
RUF, shoot, might as well. Yeah.
If you want to play really safe, you can even loop around to the to that elbow you was just looking at.
This one?
Yeah. The chances of someone being at construction versus the bushes outside the hole in wall, it's a lower chance for someone to be camping at construction. I'd keep your lasers on. I'll just Yeah, I'll just move. You don't need to fight it. If the scav's not in your way, it's no point wasting time. The area that you're running past right now, right? So the reason you went all the way around to construction was to avoid the bushes you just ran past.
Gotcha.
So just remember, where could people camp? Since you are dying to the second guy most of the time, just play safe.
Yeah.
Good stuff though. I like that. First kill was nice.
Okay.
You'd have better odds pushing in the back of fortress.
Over there?
No, the left side. Yeah. Since there's a lot more debris and stuff that you can use as cover. Because if you get caught in the open right there because you're using a keter. Yeah. I just rotate inside, man. Close distance. It's all good. Heal up. Good peeks for information.
Probably upstairs.
Yeah, I'd push upstairs, man. Remember to use your flashlight in close range. There he is. Good kill. So you see what I mean by closing the distance?
Yeah, for sure.
You have a lot better odds because people are panicking as well. Because once they like with you and you allow them, or they allow you to enter their building, they start panicking, start overthinking, and they don't know what to do. Like that guy right there didn't know what to do. He was thinking of what to do. But while he's thinking of what to do, you're already pushing him and closing the distance.
Gotcha.
So confidence is key.
I feel like I got shot from somewhere else.
I couldn't tell with the audio, but
yeah,
you can clear out the building.
Okay.
If you think there's somebody else there, I wouldn't. Yeah, you seen him.
Yeah, he's outside right there.
Yeah, you have nades.
Yes.
You seen him on your right. The cylinders, three cylinders on your right.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you have a grenade? No. Okay, I'll drop your bag if you want gonna push. Okay. Right. Since he rotated pretty quick, he's probably gonna rotate again. There you go, he rotated again.
There's another guy here.
Do remember that your body armor is half HP.
Okay. Gotcha.
Careful with leaving your flashlight on all the time. Yeah. It'll just tell him where you are. It's like a beacon. So just be careful. Get used to toggling it on and off.
Gotcha. Yeah, there's another guy here for sure too. I'm gonna try. I guess go outside and loop around this way?
No, because the other guy's out there too. Remember that?
Okay, yeah.
And since he was rotating from left to right, he's probably gonna keep rotating left to right. So you pushing out right side, you're probably just gonna give him another angle.
Gotcha.
So you can clear out the rooms. Boot room right there. I'd leave that one. Next one, fuck the loot, man. There's people in your building. If all you're doing picking up loot is you're just gonna drop a mag and you weigh more now.
For sure.
надо, козёл, нахрен, вылезай!
I'll clear our food room next.
Okay. Huh, I wonder where he went.
Well, you heard him shoot. As a player.
Oops. That's my bad.
Oh, good try. Two people. You almost had him on the second peak, but your aim was kind of all over the place. Kind of panicked.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know where I was trying to run that time.
It's the first peak. I told you like a minute before that, careful leaving your flashlight on, because you leaving your flashlight on is like a beacon of light. People can anticipate your swing. I'll show you what that looks like in offline in our next session. You don't want to keep grenades for kills unless you're using VOG 25s, which is very specific then.
Definitely, yeah.
Again, you shut the door behind you.
Oh, shit.
So, just remember that. If somebody was holding the door and then you hopped quickly into the room, you're forced to take the fight because you have no exit.
Yeah, true.
You have an impact.
How worth that impact?
It's all good. I think it gave him a concussion, so he started moving, started panicking. Good kill, though. I'll clear out the area before you loot. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
So be careful when you do throw an impact like that. You're gonna have to pull the pin off the impact before you let it go. So you might as well pull the pin and have the animation already done with. So as soon as you step out of cover, you can throw it. So you're not gotcha. Out in the open pulling the pin and hoping he doesn't land the kill shot on you.
Oh, okay. Nice.
In dorms, tell me how you would approach dorms if you heard shots.
I would usually check the first floor, open the door,
right.
Check to see if there's anyone in there, and then I guess I would push the first, right? I would usually close the door. But
I remember you did that yesterday, so,
yeah.
Alright, we're gonna replicate this, right? So, door's closed, or you go outside and then open the door and close it behind you, and then run into the room same way you've done. Right. And now what are you going to do? What are you going to do? Are you going to fight me? Are you going to fight this right-hand peak I'm holding on you right now?
Sure. Wish I had a flashbang.
Yeah, flashbang, if I heard you pull out a nade, I'd push you. You know about peaker's advantage?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to have you stand over here. And then I'm going to swing the corner. And then you try to shoot my legs, I'm going to shoot your legs, okay?
Okay.
So,
yep.
it's you have a huge advantage. Pika's advantage exists in every game, but with Tarkov, it's very extreme, that the advantage that it gives you. So that's why I say always play aggressive, be the one to swing and don't get swinged on, because if I'm swinging, I'm anticipating where you are. Do you know what I'm saying? and you can't anticipate anything. And you're stationary versus me being a movement target. So if you want to try the same thing, even with me, it'll be very hard for me to hold the corner. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
So we hit that was and that was with me anticipating it. So imagine with someone that is in an online game, they're thinking of all these different things, and then you just swing them like that.
Gotcha.
So always be the one to swing. And this was a left hand too, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
So it's also something to consider. Yo, if you're interested on getting coached in Tarkov, I am doing one-on-one coaching now. So if you're interested on why I play the way I do, you can head down to the description and sign up for coaching. Or if you want more information, click the link below that. Good luck with your raids. And also, I'm live on Twitch, like, right now.